वेलकम व्यूअर्स, आई एम संजीव कुमार ऑफ दरभंगा पब्लिक स्कूल. आई एम अ साइंस टीचर एंड टुडे इन दिस ट्यूटोरियल यू आर ऑल आर गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम एंड ऑल द पार्ट्स विच आर प्रेजेंट इन द फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम. व्हाट आर देयर रोल, फंक्शन, ईच एंड एवरीथिंग वी आर गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड इन दिस ट्यूटोरियल. You see the diagram that you are seeing, it is the diagram of female reproductive system, and a female reproductive system consists of a pair of ovaries and fallopian tube, uterus and cervix, vagina, each and everything that is shown here, it is a part of female reproductive system. And if I start telling you from the basic, that is the primary sex organs. What are the primary sex? Primary sex organs are the organs where actual gametogenesis take place. So gametogenesis take place here in ovary, and in case of female, gametogenesis is called oogenesis. So ovary is meant for production of ovum. Each every month one ovum is produced from each ovary in alternate fashion. And you see ovary is there. Ovary is connected to the uterus by a ligament called ovarian ligament. Also ovary is attached to this body wall or abdominal wall by that membranous covering, or it is called mesovarium. Mesovarium connects ovary to body wall. Okay, now you see as we have learned in the case of male, the location of male reproductive system, in that we have seen the location of the testis, it was extra abdominal, outside the abdomen. But here in this case it is not extra abdominal, it is in the abdominal, in the body itself. So, so this type of specification is not required, as we have seen in case of male. The gamete formation needs temperature about 34 degrees Celsius. Here this is not the case. So usual temperature is required, and in ovary, ovums are produced. Ovary is shown already here. Ovary is connected to uterus also by ovarian ligament, and ovary is connected to this broad ligament or this mesovarian also. Now you see this around ovary, there is a finger like projection that is emerging out from fallopian tube. These finger like projections, these are the fimbriae. Fimbriae actually covers the ovary completely, and when the ovum is released from the ovary, it is sucked inside the fallopian tube, or it is taken inside the fallopian tube. Okay, now you see the fallopian tube. Now you get to know about fallopian tube. In fallopian tube, first part is infundibulum. Infundibulum is the broad funnel like structure, and in this infundibulum you see the broad like structure. I'm showing you. You see the infundibulum, it is what, the broad funnel like structure. And after infundibulum, here the finger like projections, here these are actually fimbriae are there. You see the fimbriae. Okay, so fimbriae are there. These finger like projections, they suck the ovum when ovum is released by the ovary. After infundibulum, what we find after infundibulum, the second is ampulla. Ampulla is a little bit swollen space in fallopian tube, and after ampulla, isthmus is there. So when the ovum is produced, suppose this is the ovum is produced, ovum is pushed by the ciliary epithelium, and these cilia are going to push the ovum and and forward, or push the ovum to the ampulla region, and in ampulla region this fertilization take place. Okay, or you can say if not at ampulla, it is at the junction of isthmus and ampulla. So these two are the favorite place where fertilization take place. Fertilization is what? It is the fusion of male and female gamete. So the sperm when during copulation, sperm passes, this enters through the vagina, through the cervix, after that passing through the uterus, the sperm is a motile structure, so a sperm reaches to this ampulla region, and here it waits for the ovum. Once the ovum this released, this ovum and sperm fuse to form zygote, a diploid structure, and here fertilization takes place. Now if it is or it may take place at the junction of isthmus and ampulla also. Okay, now you, this is all about fallopian tube, and remember fallopian tube is the site where fertilization take place. So for site of fertilization is fallopian tube. Now after that you see this structure, this the pouch bag like structure here. This the head or part is fundus, at the just roof of the uterus is what, fundus, and after fundus the space, the cavity is called this body of uterus. This is the body of uterus, and after that this is the cervix, the narrow region of uterus, and in this cervix this part, this is called internal os. Means internal os here, abbreviation of orifice, internal os, and this is external os. Cervix is the narrow region, and after that this is the vagina. The opening of the vagina is called vulva, and this opening is guarded by a membranous film or covering. It is called hymen. Hymen is the symbol of virginity, but due to nowadays this hectic lifestyle, maybe it is broken, so such myth should not be created. But usually this it is guarded by this vulva is guarded by hymen, and it is the in virgin female by default it is found. Now you see this we have told, and as I think just I have to just elaborate this one only, that the wall of the uterus is three layers. If I go from outside to inside, the outermost layer of the uterine wall is called this perimetrium. Outermost wall is called perimetrium. So this is perimetrium. Okay, perimetrium, it gives the shape of the uterus. Shape of the uterus is actually determined by perimetrium. And you see this is the, after that this is the muscular wall, it is called myometrium. So myometrium is this second layer of the uterus is called myometrium. Myometrium is a muscular layer, and this is the layer in which there are receptors of oxytocin, and it gives and it helps the pregnant woman at the time of birth of the child. So during parturition this myometrium plays a significant role. And inner to the myometrium, the innermost layer of uterus is called endometrium. Endometrium, you see the wall, this the layer is not smooth, rather it has many convolutions and ridges. So it is actually richly supplied with blood vessels, and this is the third layer, and this is the layer in which this is the endometrium. And in endometrium, once the implantation is done, the blastula used to fit into the endometrium, and in endometrium placenta formation also take place. So this is the further detail I will tell you in the upcoming videos, but this is the female reproductive system. Thank you.